Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today we have one of Supermicro's powerful yet compact cloud servers, the A+ CloudDC SuperServer 1115CS-TNR. With that A+ on the name, you know it's got to have an AMD EPYC CPU. In this case, fourth generation. The system is designed for applications like cloud computing, infrastructure as a service, use as a web server or an edge node, DNS and gateway server, plus as a firewall solution. Given the low power consumption with just a single socket, it's also data center optimized to give you great value in a small footprint. If you like our videos, hit that subscribe button. Let's get to it. That single fourth generation AMD EPYC 9004 series processor can provide up to 128 Zen 4 cores and 256 virtual threads. It can support up to 3 terabytes of memory. Quite impressive, and basically the reason why they say you can replace a dual processor system with a single processor platform. Fourth generation Intel Xeon scalable CPUs max out at 60 cores and only 8 memory channels. Compare that to 12 memory channels on the fourth gen AMD EPYC 9004 series CPUs. If this system was outfitted with fourth gen Intel CPUs, you'd max out at 120 physical cores across dual sockets. But with that AMD processor installed, you get that and a few cores more with just one CPU. Not to mention more PCI lanes at up to 128, PCI 5.0 lanes. That's also why AMD says they are advancing data center performance and efficiency. The front panel features 10 hot swap SAS, SATA, NVMe 2.5-inch hybrid drive bays. However, I will note for NVMe and SAS options, you will need some additional hardware, like a storage controller if you go with SAS, and a few mini CoolEdge I/O cables if you want NVMe. The control panel on the right has the usual cast of characters. Status LEDs with system information, 2 LEDs for network interface controllers, HDDs, and power. Below those, a power on button, combo unit ID button, baseboard management controller, reset, and 2 USB 2.0 ports below those. Are you interested in this little cloud server? If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the purchase price of a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to learn more about this system. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. On the back of the system, dual 860-watt platinum level power supply units on the left. That's the only option you get on this system. Aside from the fact that for Europe, they get titanium level. Next, 2 advanced I/O module slots, which are OCP 3.0 compatible for network communications. Between those, a VGA port, BMC LAN port, 2 USB 3.0 ports, a COM port, and a unit ID LED. 2 full-height, half-length PCI slots above. Inside the system, it looks neat and uncluttered. The 2 risers each featuring a x16 PCI 5.0 slot capable of supporting a single-width GPU, NIC, or high drive controller. Below those, you can see the slots for the OCP mezzanine cards, each of which offers a x16 PCI 5.0 interface. There are several options for connection speed and ports. GPUs supported in those PCI risers include the NVIDIA A2 with 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory and the L4 with 24 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. The A2 is a slightly older generation with Ampere architecture, and the L4 features Ada Lovelace architecture. Both are power sippers with the A2 at up to 60 watts and the L4 at up to 72 watts. That said, the L4 does offer more performance with 6 times the CUDA cores and 2x the memory, although it is also about 4 times the cost in comparison. Budgetary factors are a consideration. 2 slots on the system board featuring a PCI 3.0 with a x2 link width enable support for 2 NVMe M.2 drives, specifically to boot the system. You can install 1, or if you want redundancy, 2, and mirror the drives with RAID 1. 4 NVMe connections on the side of the CPU and memory module slots are for connecting NVMe drives 0 through 7. Mirrored on the other side are 4 more connectors. Those nearest the fan support NVMe drives 8 through 11, with the other 2 connectors supporting up to 8 SATA drives apiece. Yes, this system does only support 10 drives, however the H13 SSW motherboard is used in other A+ systems, perhaps one that supports 12 2.5-inch drive bays. The CPU installed on the system is an AMD EPYC 9254 with 24 cores and 48 threads, 128 megabytes of L3 cache, and a TDP of 200 watts. This system is capable of supporting air-cooled CPUs with a TDP of up to 360 watts. Paired with 12 32-gigabyte registered DDR5 memory modules, it currently has 384 gigabytes running at 4800 megatransfers per second. As there are 12 memory channels and only 12 memory module slots, memory speed is optimized at 1 DIMM per channel. If you wanted the full 128 cores of processing power, then you could go with an AMD EPYC 9754 CPU. Fourth gen AMD EPYC CPUs are certainly capable of supporting more than the 3 TB max possible on this system, but with only 12 memory module slots and not 24, 3 TB is the limit. With 24 slots, you could achieve up to 6 TB of memory. Only registered memory modules are supported. This platform is purpose-built for efficiency and performance and comes with a minimal configuration. Not a whole lot of options, but it does provide a great deal of flexibility to handle a variety of applications. Some of those other servers I've reviewed recently are just one option after another with lots of restrictions on configuration. It's like if you put this in and then you can't have that, and if you want that, then you need this, and this will require that, and so on and so forth. The Supermicro CloudDC A Plus SuperServer 1115CS-TNR is a breath of fresh air in that respect. In many ways, it's just like this video, short and to the point. If you're looking for something like this, hit one of those links I left in the description or that one right there, itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.